Well, you guys, as of 3:30 today, it's almost the end of the market hours. As you guys can see, the Dow was rising up a little bit, slowly recovering. But as we continue to get more bad news of the situation going on, as you guys can see, the market is starting to sell off right before the close as of Friday. Yo, what is up, you guys, and welcome to another video. My name is Benjie, and this is week number 21 of investing with the Robinhood app. If you guys are new here, this is my portfolio. As you guys see on the screen, this is my live portfolio. The number up here is the entire portfolio of all the stocks that I currently own at the prices that the shares are currently at. This is what the entire portfolio is worth currently on the screen right here, just over $52,000 currently. My portfolio is made up of around 35 to 40 different companies. I'm not exactly sure, I haven't counted in a while, of different companies that do pay dividends every single month or every single quarter, depending on what the frequency of the dividends that are paid out from each company is. The companies that I choose to invest in must pay dividends. That's one of the criteria for me to invest in a company, but they also have to have the ability to grow over time, because over time, along with getting paid out dividends along the way, I also want this overall number, the overall value of the portfolio, to go up significantly over time. In today's video, I want to show you guys where the portfolio is sitting at and where it's been moving over the last week. It has been moving quite a bit. This has been one of the most volatile weeks in the market of all time, and definitely my most volatile week in the market, considering I have only been investing in the stock market for a matter of weeks at this point, as you guys can see in my all-time portfolio right here. I also want to share with you guys all the new stocks that I have purchased over the last day or two and tell you guys exactly why I did purchase them, what the dividend yields are currently at, etc. And finally, I want to share with you guys some not so great news. One of the companies in my portfolio officially cut their dividend. All right, so let's get right into it. Today, my portfolio opened at right around $54,000. Then it dipped to around 52 and a half, went back up to about 54 and a half. As you guys can see, it's been quite a crazy day for the prices of the stocks overall. And currently we are pretty close to the close of the market as of Friday. We are currently at 3:36 p.m. And as you guys can see, it is starting to sell off again. And the portfolio is losing more and more value as time goes on currently. So that's where we're sitting at as far as today. For last week, let's take a look at this. We are down $5,196, almost 10%. The last month, we are down $25,259, over 30% in the last month. The last 3 months is basically the same. We're down 24,000 and some change. And then for the last year, since I started this portfolio, just a matter of a few weeks ago, a matter of 20 weeks ago or so, we are down around $24,000 or down 30%. Now, before you guys go ahead and freak out, keep in mind this is a very, very long-term portfolio. I'm using money that I don't need for quite a bit of time to invest in this portfolio. This is all money that has been set aside for quite some time. So I am gradually investing into a ton of different companies and adding shares where I see value. And over time, my outlook is around 10, 20, 30 years from now. Over that span of time, I really hope that this number, of course, can go up and of course can be not in the minus, of course, hopefully be in the positive. And with the amount of shares rising, I'll have dividends that are compounding and buying me more shares of different stocks. So keep in mind, this number is down quite a bit right now, but in the grand scheme of things, we're only a matter of weeks into this portfolio. We're only in the matter of months since I started this portfolio, and we are in this for the long run. This is a very long-term portfolio. Now, if this was a day trading or swing trading portfolio, for example, in the hopes of buying different shares of different companies and then hopefully selling them within a day or even a week or two and trying to get a profit out of it, then yes, you could say this is an absolute disaster. But keep in mind, I'm buying these companies because I want to be paid out the dividends. I want to get yield off of the money that I invest into these companies. And over time, overall, I'll be gaining in the overall price of the shares in the long term. Right before we go ahead and take a look at all the new companies that I have bought over the last few days, I definitely want to share them all with you guys. If you guys don't already have the Robinhood app, Robinhood is a brokerage that I use to buy all the stocks on. It's the app that you guys saw on the last previous screen. I've been using it for quite some time. I really like the Robinhood app. If you guys download it and you guys don't already have an account, if you download it right here in all my descriptions and click the freestock.robinhood.com, this one right here, the link right here in all my descriptions, you'll receive a free stock and I'll receive a free stock. I think they're valued between like $3 and $100 or something. So there's really nothing to lose. It's the best time to get into the market right now because the market is down, in my opinion, of course. If you guys don't already have the Robinhood app, feel free to use my link right here and I definitely appreciate it. So I did go ahead and buy quite a few new stocks over the last few days. While the market has still been down, there's still tons of value that I've been seeing in the overall market. So first, I bought one share of Home Depot at $162.99. as we see right here, Home Depot is continuing to fall right before the end of the market as of Friday here. I might go ahead and grab another share while I'm making this video, actually, funny enough, but the price that I got it a little bit above that. The dividend yield currently is right around 4%. I think I did the math and it's right around 4% of where I got in at. And again, to be invested in a company like Home Depot and earn a 4% yield, for a company like Home Depot that will go back up in price in the long term, I definitely think so. It's down quite a bit from the high. I mean, it was trading at 241 just a matter of weeks ago. I think Home Depot will recover in the long term, and this is one that I'll continue to dollar cost average, definitely. The next one that I bought four more shares of was Wells Fargo at 27.05. Wells Fargo, another one continuing to get beat up by the market, down almost 7% as of today. The dividend yield currently for Wells Fargo is absolutely great at over 7% dividend yield. Payout ratio is creeping up there, but I still feel like there is room. They've been paying a dividend for quite some time, and I really think that they are probably going to keep their dividend around. Even if they were to cut their dividend in half, per se, that's still a really good yield in your money, considering we're in a market right now where it's very hard to find decent yields. So this is another one I'll continue to dollar cost average in as well. I've held this one for a while, and I'm just trying to lower my overall average price. Next one of my favorites, I bought one more share of Starbucks at $61.87. Starbucks is one of my favorite companies in my overall portfolio right now because I do see some of the most growth potential long term with Starbucks in the future here. I feel like this one could double in price in the next few years here once everything gets settled in the markets and in the economy. The Starbucks dividend yield is close to 3%, which again in these markets is actually not too bad, especially considering the amount of growth potential in a stock like Starbucks. They've been paying out their dividend also for quite some time. I'm actually at a pretty good average cost for Starbucks. Oddly enough, I've been able to really average down and get my overall cost for all the shares that I own at Starbucks pretty close to $60. So very proud of that. The next one that I bought two shares of was Verizon at $51.60 a share. Verizon is one company that I could see continuing to go down in price with the entire market situation, everything going on. But with the price that it's at and the yield that it's offering, and their dividend yield looks pretty good too at a 4.59%. As it goes down in price from the average price that I'm holding into, I'll keep buying a few shares here and there. And the next one that I bought two shares of was IBM at $97.83 per share. IBM is definitely not one of my favorite companies. This is definitely not a company that I want to be super, super invested into. But where the price is at right now, it's at the 52-week low as of today. And the amount of potential that IBM does have to go up in value in the short slash long term, as well as the dividend yield being at almost 7% currently, I really couldn't resist. I had to grab a few more shares of IBM. Their payout ratio is creeping up as well. But they have tons of dividend growth long term. They've paid out dividends through a lot of different market cycles. And overall, as long as IBM can keep paying a dividend even near this, I'd be more than happy to hold on to it for the long term. Next, one of my favorites, got three more shares of Realty Income at $49.73. Realty Income has really sold off as of the last few days. It's currently at $47.62. The dividend yield that that's paying is 5.82%. And for a monthly paying dividend stock like Realty Income, that is one of the highest dividend yields that it's been paying, obviously, in quite some time. So I will keep loading up shares of Realty Income. I believe in this company long term. I know with the market situations, real estate, this is a REIT. I know that real estate is going to have a lot of challenges with everything being closed. It's an overall great company that I'm really willing to stick around for the long term. I also got two more shares of Starbucks at $60.89. I grabbed one more share of Altria at $35.65. Altria has also sold off pretty significantly over the last few days, last few weeks. The reason I bought a few more shares this one, the dividend yield, I couldn't resist at a 9.06% dividend yield. The payout ratio is creeping up along with pretty much everything else in the market. The dividend growth, 50 years though, that's pretty tempting to keep buying more shares this one because it does show that they have grown their dividend through different market cycles, different recessions, etc. I'm not really so sure about this one. That's why I only bought a share. I'll probably continue to dollar cost average if it does go down a little bit more, but I will be very careful with this one. This isn't necessarily one of my top picks, but I had to grab another share because the price was down and the dividend yield is just too good to pass up. Next, I bought three more shares of AT&T at $28.56. This is honestly pretty crazy to see AT&T trading at under $30. When I first started investing into dividend stocks a few months ago, I looked into AT&T, and this was one that a lot of dividend investors were really keen on. The price for AT&T was much higher than this when I first started investing a few months ago and got a few shares of it. So continuing to try to dollar cost average and get my overall average price better with AT&T. The dividend yield currently at just over 6.5% is very, very favorable for me. I think AT&T will make it through the storm. I think that they'll come out the other side stronger than ever. The payout ratio is creeping up a little bit too, but again, they've been through different market cycles. I think AT&T definitely has the potential to make it through this and raise the overall price of the stock over time, as well as keep the dividend hopefully as safe as possible. I also bought another share, IBM, at 103 yesterday. Yesterday, I got a few more stocks. Whirlpool, I grabbed a Kimberly-Clark, Coca-Cola, more AT&T, etc. Now for some unfortunate news. Ford suspends dividend, raises cash to ride out the outbreak. Ford is a company that I've been holding for a while, as you guys see right here. And luckily enough for me, I'm only holding 16 shares of Ford currently. So the fact that they did suspend their dividend doesn't hurt all that much compared to how much it would hurt from some of the other holdings that I have in my portfolio. But Ford did go ahead and suspend the dividend, unfortunately, which is the main reason that I even invested into Ford in the first place. I really don't love Ford as a company. I was hearing some good things about it from certain people because of the new electric cars that they're supposed to be coming out with. I'm not really a fan of Ford cars personally. I don't really like the company all that much personally. But I did go ahead and get a few shares because the dividend yield was so attractive at the time. I think it was at like a 7% dividend yield with a somewhat reasonable payout ratio. So I did go ahead and grab a few shares. I'm luckily only at a $60 overall loss for all of the shares of Ford that I have currently. So again, it could be much worse. There's other companies that I have a lot more shares of in my portfolio that would really hurt a lot more if they suspended their dividend. And keep this in mind, you guys, with everything going on in the market and in the world right now, a lot of companies will in fact suspend their dividends moving forward here. I don't know exactly how many, of course. I don't know which ones, of course, but companies at risk and companies that need to conserve as much cash as possible, they'll probably suspend paying out their dividends. I will try to get rid of Ford as soon as possible. Honestly, there's no use for it in my portfolio anymore if it doesn't pay a dividend. And honestly, personally, I don't really expect Ford to raise that much in price in the long term. I could be wrong, but I really don't believe in Ford as a company all that much in the long term. So I really did go away from my overall strategy when I bought a few shares this one, hence probably why I only bought a matter of a few shares, literally. But I'll be trying to unload this as soon as possible, hopefully with the least amount of damage as possible in the overall return. And I'll just take this as a lesson. Honestly, I really need to stick to companies that do fit in my strategy, companies that pay out a dividend, which the dividend is very safe, as well as companies that will in fact be around for a long time, and companies that overall have a lot of potential to raise the price of their overall stock price over the long term. Well, guys, that's going to do it for today's video. What an absolute crazy week it has been this week. I hope all of you guys are staying healthy. I hope all you guys are staying safe. I hope all of you guys are staying calm during all this market turmoil. It's been really interesting for me, all the different emotions, all the ups and downs, even through the last week and, of course, the weeks before that. And man, has it been an exciting time to be invested into the stock market. It's been really cool to try to buy into a lot of these companies at prices that I would have never dreamed of getting into them at. But at the same time, there's so much unknowns about everything that's going on. So it's just a continuous cycle of thinking about things one way and then going to the whole other side. I do that throughout the day quite often. If you guys did like this video, please give me a big thumbs up on this video. That really helps my channel get around YouTube. If you guys haven't already, please subscribe to my channel. I'll be posting a video on Monday showing you guys all the different stocks that I'm buying. I have quite a bit of cash in my portfolio finally, and I just deposited another $7,000. So we finally got a little bit more cash to work with the portfolio, and I will be depositing a little bit more aggressively moving forward here. This is definitely the time to buy, you guys. We do not know where the bottom of the market is, of course. I think we can all agree that there's definitely some buying opportunities right now, even though this might not be the absolute bottom of the market. We'll see what happens. Thank you guys so much again for watching. Please stay calm and stay safe out there, and I'll see you guys in the next video.